23 now. Roberts nearly went onto that concrete patch there. And what an indication of what a very, very cool rider. And is that Hartog? That's Hartog behind Sheen. Will Hartog is putting in a tremendous burst and he's closing up on Barry Sheen. Will Hartog, who was some 5 seconds behind these two in the closing stages of the race, is piling on the power and he's caught right up with the two in front of him. Barry Sheen on a work Suzuki like Hartog that you're looking at now. Number three, the Dutchman from Aberkek, the grass farmer who won at Hockenheim. And it looks as though Hartog, if he goes the way he is going now, could end up winning this race. He's caught up a tremendous amount in terms of time and distance on Sheen and Roberts. Sheen second, Roberts leads, Hartog third. First, second and third go round the right-hander. They're absolutely together. The end of lap 23 at Woodcote. 28 lap race. And between Roberts and Hartog, there is very considerably less than a second. You can see how close it is. And Hartog is some 18 seconds ahead of Virginio Ferrari. 12, 15 points for a win in the World Championship. 12 for second, 10 for third. And Hartog takes Sheen. No, he doesn't. He drops back. Very, very close. Sheen just held him off. And Sheen goes through. It's incredible the way they close right up and then have to drop back. So Roberts holds the lead. Barry Sheen still in second place. Lap 24 out of 28. Down the hangar straight, which is the fastest part for Kenny Roberts on the Yamaha. And quietly, Will Hartog cut that distance down between himself and Sheen with an absolutely incredible ride, and there's absolutely nothing in it as they go round Stowe for the 24th time. There's the Dutchman. Yamaha, Suzuki, Suzuki out of Club Corner up towards Abbey. 150 miles an hour. Under the bridge, fastest point of the course. Shut off quick, down into Woodcote. Robert Sheen Hartog. Start, lap 25. Cops Corner. Just a flick of concrete dust as Robert's front wheel hit it. Sixth gear. 145 miles an hour. Maggots. Straighten it up. Down through the box. Fifth, fourth, third, second gear. Beckett's. 7,500 RPM, 65 miles an hour. Roberts, Sheen, Hartog. Up through the gears. Third as they go into Chapel. Fourth, fifth, sixth. 11,000 RPM, 160 miles an hour. Down to Stowe, fifth, fourth, third gear, 100 miles an hour. Hartog, ahead of him, Sheen and Roberts. Fifth gear, 150 miles an hour. Down to third for Club, 100 miles an hour, the right-hander. Now up through the box again. To fourth, to fifth, to Abbey, the left-hander. Sixth gear, 10,300 RPM. And into Woodcote at the end of lap 25 out of 28. Now, two tail enders going to be lapped. Past 52, Corradi Tutsi they go. Up to number 53, Henk de Vries. And past him go Roberts and Sheen. And Roberts goes straight through the oil patch. Hartog has been held up. Hartog has been held up by De Vries, but he's passed him. And now he's got to regain that distance he's lost to Barry Sheen, who's in second place there on lap 26. After this lap, lap 27, and then into the last lap, 28, and Sheen riding up alongside the outside of Kenny Roberts, who's got the tighter line and holds his lead as he goes into the left-hander at Chapel and down the hangar straight again for the 26th time. Ferrari is still fourth, Van Dalman is still sixth, Sarron fifth, Sarron is still sixth. In seventh position, it's still Coulon. And Hartog pulling away from Ferrari. It was 18 seconds, it's now 23. But Hartog, who was held up by Henk de Vries, is going to have his work cut out to catch Barry Sheen, let alone get past him, let alone catch Kenny Roberts, let alone take the lead. And he is on the last lap but two, coming up to complete lap 26, into lap 27, and the last lap is 28. Roberts, the gap between Roberts, the leader, and Hartog in third place is 1.41 seconds as they go under the bridge and down to Copse on lap 27. The pit signals are going out. Roberts looks over his shoulder. He sees Barry Sheen there. Barry Sheen looks over his shoulder and sees further behind him than he is behind Kenny Roberts, the Dutch rider, Will Hartog. This is Beckett's. Chapel. Roberts, Sheen, Hartog. American, Englishman, Dutchman. Yamaha, Suzuki, Suzuki. Hangar straight. Into Stowe Corner. Ice cool Kenny. King Kenny, they call him. Arguably, certainly one of the greatest riders of all time, and definitely, I think, the greatest all-rounder of all time, because he has been AMA champion, American Motorcycle Association champion, and that means that you have to be able to ride speedway and their kind of TT racing, which is very different to ours, and be a real all-rounder. And they're coming up to Woodcote at the end of lap 27 to start lap 28, and with that tail-ender in front of Barry Sheen, now Kenny Roberts goes through 0.69, 69 hundredths of a second ahead of Sheen, and that could well have decided the race in favour of Kenny Roberts, because Barry Sheen is just far enough behind Roberts, I think. Roberts even stands on the rest a little to look back there, but again he's got two tail-enders in front of him, and Barry Sheen is indiscernibly gaining. Roberts into Beckett's. Sheen behind him. Roberts goes through on the inside of the tail-ender, and the tail-ender looks to me very much like Gianni Rolando, the Italian rider. Roberts is past him. Sheen is past him. Down the hangar straight for the last time. The 28th time in this 28-lap race. Into Stowe Corner for the last time at 100 miles an hour. It's going to be one of the closest Grand Prix finishes for a very, very long time. Sheen is far enough ahead of Will Hartog not to have to worry about the Dutchman as they go to Club Corner. The last but one right-hander on the circuit, because they're coming up to Abbey, and is Barry Sheen going to be able to do anything about it? I doubt it. But Kenny Roberts goes into Abbey. It's that close, you can hardly divide them on the stopwatch. From Abbey up to Woodcote, underneath the bridge, is going to be tremendously close as they go into the last corner of the race. This is it at 130 miles an hour. The chequered flag is out. Kenny Roberts and Barry Sheen is gaining, gaining, gaining. And there is less than a machine's length in it, with a fantastic race, with Will Hartog finishing in third place. And Kenny Roberts won the 1979 Marlborough British Grand Prix at record speed, undoubtedly having shattered the lap record by less than a very, says, few, as he shakes his hand. That was indeed, he says, a very close run thing. Barry Sheen has every reason to feel absolutely delighted.